February 12th, 21. Great to have you today. Thank you for joining me on this journey to pursue God and seek everything that He has for us today. Ensure that we are equipped for opportunities and the challenges. So let's get started. A reminder that we are having live service this Sunday. We are running transportation and we will be meeting at the chapel in a reduced capacity while we continue to navigate through COVID-19. However, if you are not able to attend or you have not made a reservation, you will find us on Facebook at 10 o'clock Sunday morning. So look for us there. It's the next best thing. Certainly we enjoy getting together and seeing everyone, but we recognize the constraints and the safety precautions and the things that you are facing in order to make sure that we eradicate this COVID-19 that has stayed with us longer than anyone expected. So join us Sunday, 10 o'clock. I'll see you there. So we wrap up this week's devotion. If you recall yesterday, or several days, we spent in Isaiah. But yesterday we talked about perhaps gaining a better perspective on the burden that Jesus carried to the cross. That we recognize that our law enforcement, our military, our healthcare workers, firemen, emergency respond, all of those people put their lives on the line for us on a daily basis. And they share that in common with Jesus, who put his life on the line. But where it differs is the scope. And that's what we really need to have an understanding of, what exactly was accomplished through Jesus' crucifixion and resurrection. And as we discussed yesterday, it was carrying the guilt of everyone who has ever been born prior to Jesus' death, and everyone who will ever be born until Jesus' return. He stood in for you and took your sentence. He stood in for me. He stood in for everyone. When we start considering that, we start at least on the path to having a deeper understanding of the burden that he carried. And as mentioned, I don't even think that does it justice. I don't think we'll ever comprehend just how much of a sacrifice God made for you and I. So, with that as our backdrop for today, I'd like to take a look at a passage out of Hebrews that talks about our relationship with God, our choice and our commitment to that relationship, and that we shouldn't take it lightly. From Hebrews 6, starting in verse 4, it is impossible for those who have once been enlightened, who have once tasted the heavenly gift, who have shared in the Holy Spirit, who have tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the powers of the coming age, and who have fallen away, to be brought back to repentance. This passage has tremendous amount of impact. And here's why. First and foremost, I need to mention, as I mentioned a few weeks ago, that we are in the gospel business. We are in the business of sharing salvation. We are not in the judgment business. That is our Father's job. However, for our own personal sake and for the sake of those that we are called to teach, we and they need to be aware that the cycling that we witnessed in the Old Testament of kind of coming in and out of relationship with God isn't healthy. And there comes a point when that in and out relationship with God has consequences. Now, I've spoken in the past, and I'll kind of touch on it again here today, of yes, we can take this as kind of a dark and foreboding passage of a negative. What happens if we lose faith? We can't get it back. Well, to that question, I often respond to people who are joining us on Sunday that if you are here on Sunday, you can be assured that God is calling you back into relationship. However, what this passage is speaking of is there's a point where you travel beyond being able to hear from God and respond to God and be brought back to that place where you would lay down your life. But instead of seeing this as a negative, I want you to understand how I read this passage and how it helps me in my daily walk with God. It reminds me of what a privilege it is to be in relationship with God and to not take that relationship lightly, even in times when I don't understand, even in times when my faith is being tested. And I call that the point of no return, that I am so invested in my relationship with God, it is the centerpiece of everything that I am, that on the bad days, what may at some point in my relationship with God caused me to just flush it all and say, I'm going to try Scientology, that option is no longer even on the table because I am so far into my relationship with God. And that's a comfort in times when I, you know, just as everyone, struggle in one circumstance or another. Harm to a loved one, death of a loved one, financial strain, the path turning unexpectedly, if you recall, are much afraid. All of those tests of faith, once you become aware of the level of commitment required, and you choose to be all in, you reach those points and you recognize there's no other place to turn, that your counsel, your confidant, the strength, the power, the source of everything, are you just to give that up? And we could think of this in terms of our own personal relationships, for those of us that were married, that settling into a relationship, feels like there's less weight of that relationship. Now, truly, I am in marriage counseling. My desire is to get you to the point to recognize that this is a lifelong commitment and not something of just being more serious than just dating. But nevertheless, the further we get into our marriages, the more we recognize that it is a commitment for life. And that we are beyond the point of no return, that there's we are so deep into this relationship that we are going to give it our all each and every day. And the sooner that we get to that point, the sooner that we recognize it's all in, and that's what we're called to, truly the better we are, the more at peace we are, the more capable we are of walking in that commitment for the rest of our days. Now, why this has such weight, and why this, I bring this in comparison to what we learned yesterday out of Isaiah, is for the final bit of this passage. To their loss, they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace. The author of Hebrews is emphasizing that before we make any decision to walk away from our relationship with God, we should first understand the sacrifice and how much faithfulness and commitment God showed to us. And Jesus demonstrated on the cross, and that our choices not only have consequences for ourselves, the cycling is weightier than we even considered. That to move in and out of relationship with God is asking Jesus to be crucified again. And since we lack the comprehension to understand the weight of that burden, initially, certainly, asking Jesus to do that again, we have a better understanding of why it's so difficult once we are, by every measure, committed to a relationship with God to just choose a different way. Boundaries. An understanding of the boundaries. Understanding that the boundaries are put into place out of love and mercy and grace, and they're made clear, is something that God wants all of us to have an understanding of. Now, I reiterate from one last time that is not our job to judge those who are outside of a relationship with God and suggest that they have no place in the family of God. We are called to share the gospel, share the love of Jesus with everyone. And prayerfully, They'll return and find a rich relationship with God, a more committed relationship with God than they had in the past. But is there a point that that's no longer possible? Yes. And that's something that should weigh on us as we make our decisions on how fully committed we are to God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this week that you helped us navigate through once again. It had its own challenges, it had its own curves in the road that we weren't expecting. Through it all, Lord, you were there, fully committed to us. And gratefully, Lord, you have cemented us into our relationship to where, no matter where this path takes us, we choose you. Thank you, Lord, for encouraging us deeper and deeper into relationship. To not take our relationship with you for granted as just the latest fix, but to earnestly seek you and pattern our ways after you, for your glory and honor, and for our well-being, for our eternity. We recognize, Lord, that the boundaries have been put into place so that we will find our way home. We thank you for your love and your mercy and your grace, and we thank you for the sacrifice that you made while we were far away from you. We pray, Lord, that your mercy and grace would fall upon those that you've called us to reach, that you would open the eyes of our neighbors, allow them to see as we see. Allow them to know you as we know you. Equip us today, Lord, to face any challenges that come our way. Help us to recognize the opportunities that you are placing before us and discern opportunities while parsing temptation and detours. Lord, we pray for our nation, we pray for our loved ones, we pray for our enemies. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. All right, have a great weekend. I will see you Sunday at 10 o'clock and back here at 8 o'clock on Monday. Love you. I miss you. Until we see each other again, be good.